I'm so happy now to have you, Ben. We talked about many different opportunities to analyze and get the data, but I'm sure there's a way to visualize the data, and I think that's what you want to talk about.
Yeah, that's a great segue. Thank you, Frank. Definitely. So obviously we have experiences in the portal, and I know you had a segment where we talked about exporting that data, but I also wanted to show you what you can do with that exported data, as well as a couple of options that you have, especially working with Power BI. One of the things we have is a Power BI template app. And this template app is available and free to download. A link will be provided. And this is, you can think of this as kind of a jumping off point. This gives you some pre-canned reports that hopefully are helpful, but are really, really meant to get you started in kind of viewing and working with your cost data, especially helpful in taking that cost data and combining it with any other business critical data you have to come up with a holistic picture of your Azure cost management. So I'm not gonna talk through all the reports here because there are a lot. I just wanna call out a couple of the ones that I think are key that might be really helpful and beneficial to you. And once I'm done showing that, I kind of want to show you, again, this is the pre-canned report. I also want to show you that we also have a Power BI connector that's built into the Power BI desktop that you can build your own reports as well. So just diving right in here, the first one is the usage by services.
Oh, yeah.
So this gives you kind of a view over the time that you entered, the however many months you've selected, of how much services are costing you in a given period of time. On its own, not super interesting, but what it does do is call out trends. And I think that's key to note, especially here. You can see this line kind of trailing up. If you want to figure out what that is. So suddenly you see costs kind of increasing. You're not quite sure what it was. It's not necessarily a planned deployment or planned scale out. You could simply just click into the line and the panel down here will tell you what it is. So this, for some reason, my Azure firewall started costing me more in the month of November. Could be, you know, totally expected, but this is just an area for you to kind of look in and understand where your costs are going.
Yeah. Same thing. It's important to say, because in Power BI, if someone is not yet used to that, everything is interactive. So you click at some place and then like it apply filters or sort somewhere else. So
yeah, that's
interactive. That's very interesting then. Yeah.
Correct. Yeah. The levels of interactivity with Power BI are fantastic. And just like what you said, you can kind of filter and sort based on your selections. I mean, I can choose different things here, like this one kind of increased in the month of September. If I want to figure out what that is, again, it filtered my table and it's telling me it's disaster recovery for my storage account. So this is one of the key things I wanted to call out. This is really helpful in kind of allowing you to track over time and see where you're trending, especially. And also call out anomalies. So you can figure that out if you see, you know, costs increasing suddenly. That kind of gives you the ability to kind of narrow in to figure out what that is. So this is kind of a popular report that I wanted to call out, and I just want to jump over to the next one. So this is something that we don't really have a good portal experience today. So we try to make up for it in Power BI. We do in the future want to have better coverage of this, and we are making strides there. But what this is if you have hybrid benefits, and what hybrid benefits allows you to do is if you've previously purchased a Windows license, you can reuse for on-prem, you can reuse that license in the cloud for a Windows VM and save additional monies. So this kind of tells you, gives you a view of how many VMs are using hybrid benefits. Same thing here, you can kind of see the amount of servers that have hybrid benefits enabled, as well as the cores that are used. And then these two panels here, we give you, I don't want to say a recommendation, but a suggestion. This right here gives you where you're using hybrid benefits where it's less than 8 cores. If you're using hybrid benefits on a VM, it needs to be, I mean, ideally, it's a license equates, you can split a license in half and be 2 8 cores, and it can't go any lower than 8 cores. So if you're using a license on a one core VM, again, I just selected this and it filters, it's probably not an optimal use of that license. You probably want to use that on an 8 or more core license. So again, this is where it's potentially underutilizing that license. And this is where you're not using it all, where you can get more money from, more savings from. So if I click over here, this shows me that it's an 8-core VM. This is how many it would go against in hybrid benefits. And it's obviously it's not enabled yet. So this gives you kind of two views into if you're using it with less than 8 cores, and if it's greater than 8 cores or greater and you're not using it, it's kind of a contrast compare. So you can maximize your savings benefit with hybrid benefits. Reservation recommendations. So this is a report that we created to kind of give you at scale for your entire enrollment the ability to see reservation recommendations. So it breaks it out if you already have RI versus what you're paying on demand, as well as allows you to drill into the different regions. And again, it filters the table and kind of shows you the skew and the quantity you can purchase. Again, it's also filterable by 1 and 3 years. So this is really to assist, not only show you where you're using your RI or how much RI you're consuming, but also where you could consume or where you could purchase more RI for additional savings benefit. So this is a shared view. I also got for a single subscription, but I just wanted to call that out.
10 seconds, you want to show, like you want to mention about the connectors?
Oh, good call. Yes. Go into Power BI Desktop and then select Get Data. Once that comes up, choose Azure. And this is what you want. You want the Azure Cost Management connector. This is going to come up and ask you to input some things. Your enrollment number. So that would be your enrollment number that you'd put in here, as well as a number of months. And then voila, that will connect up and give you some options to pull the data you've seen down in these reports down locally to use in your creation of any sort of Azure cost management reporting needs in Power BI.
Wonderful. And we'll sure to include information for people to help them getting started in the show notes. But now, It's time for the live questions. Thank you.